This will be part four to the Illuminati card game series, and it's interesting because the more research you do on these cards, the more cards you find and the more interesting things that you find. So I think we're going to get a real interest out of the ones today. But here, as you can see, this shows Madison Avenue, and it says, "You need more stuff. It is morally wrong to allow suckers to keep their money. Canada Bill Jones has plus 10 for any direct group or any media group, or gives plus 2 on any attempt to control or destroy any media group." Wow, we see that going on in America, especially today. Keep on buying stuff, buy, 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 spend, spend, spend. And we also see that with banks too. Why do you think that banks give you such a hard time just to withdraw your money out of the banks, or to withdraw in bulk? Why do you think they want you to keep all your money in the bank? Because according to them, it's morally wrong for you to have money. What control of the money? Control of the banks. They want to control everything. They want to control you. And that is exactly how they do, because if they can control currency, they can control you. Why do you think they're pushing for this new world currency with the RFID chip? I'll let you answer that on your own. But of course, you cannot have a new world order without pyramid marketing schemes, because we know where the pyramid comes from. Hint, hint, Egypt. But this says, tell your people to buy, 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 because that's exactly what they want you to do. Keep buying stuff that you don't need, and keep making the people on the top get richer and richer off of you by getting stuff you don't need. Like, for example, Air Jordans. I know they're hot and I know everybody wants them, but are they really needed? And by the way, why does it cost so much just to get a pair of sneakers or a pair of gym shoes or just anything? Like, have we ever considered why it's so expensive to get certain things and certain clothes? Why it costs $200 to get a pair of Louis Vuittons or whatever, or why it costs in the thousands to get a pairs of watches and all these things? What is it? Capitalism, mind control. They want you to keep spending on things you don't need, and they know you don't need it, because what? Then you won't have any money to get the things that you really do need in case of an emergency, and it keeps these guys at the top. Who? The Zionists. It's time to wake up and see the agenda for what it really is. Now, I thought this one was interesting because it says survivalists, and it says this group gives your whole power structure plus 3 to resist any disaster. The master of the survivalists and any puppets it has automatically get relief the turn after any devastation. This is a free action. And as you can see behind it, you see toilet paper, ammo, beer, ammo, beer. Now, I thought this was interesting because we know what a lot is going on right now with preppers and prepping. Now, I know it shows a picture of what looks to be someone in the army, but it's just interesting because also shows what? It shows what? Prepping, survival, and plus they're going after and targeting preppers as well. So why would they even make this card to begin with, unless they knew something ahead of time, unless they knew something that we didn't? Now, I thought this card was also interesting because it is very reminiscent of what? Facebook. Now, like I said, I don't know the actual history of Facebook, but I do know that a lot of Facebook, of course, the story can go many different ways, but it's just interesting because it sort of reminds you of that the very first time that you see it. And also, you can do research on Mark Zuckerberg and you'll find out just who he really is. Hint, hint, he has something to do with the New World Order and the Rockefellers. You can even look at the jacket that he wears and what's inside of his jacket, and you'll see just who he works for. So here we have a picture of our favorite, the CDC, or the Center for Disease Control, another alphabet soup. Now, why is this card so important? Because what is the CDC really behind? Well, they're behind partially what? The Zika virus hoax and all the other so-called diseases, AIDS and everything. They're the ones responsible for all that stuff, because what do they do? Well, first of all, they hire puppets like Bill Gates to go into third world countries and to cause diseases there, and to cause diseases via vaccines. They cause the problem and then offer their own solution, which is to poison and sicken you even more. Oh, what a real new world agenda they have. Oh, what an agenda indeed. As well as poisoning your water and responsible for poisoning food and other pandemics and diseases as well. And it wouldn't surprise me if they're the ones, as well as the WHO, that's behind the so-called Ebola hoax and other so-called diseases. Why? Because they want to spread a pandemic in order to what? Put you into FEMA camps and quarantine you into places like Walmart and other places. It's only a matter of time until they do that. It's only a matter of time until they announce these nefarious plans to your face. But you'll be ready ahead of time, won't you? But they're gonna need some help because they can't do it alone. Because why? Who is also in charge of all this? Agents and intelligence agents, alphabet soups. They also have cards showing the FBI and the CIA as well. But this one is the MI5, and it says the British intelligence agencies have been hiding things in plain sight since the First World War, at least. Because what are they responsible for? All the so-called terrorist attacks, and they help fund both of the wars, child trafficking, human trafficking, sex trafficking, and drug trafficking, as well as other heinous crimes that they can't tell you about. Why aren't they going to tell it to your face? Because they've been hiding it to you right in plain sight. But you haven't seen it, have you? But now it's time to awake and see just who's behind all these nefarious things. Now, I thought this card was interesting because it shows Hitler's brain, and it says, no, it's not exactly alive, but it's not dead, and we can feel its dreams. Was he illuminated himself? You're not cleared for that, but the evil brain lies plotting, twisting the souls around it. Now, a few things about Hitler. First of all, Hitler did not die when they said he did. He did not commit suicide in 1945 or whatever it was. He was taken to either Argentina or Brazil to help start and fund Project Monarch, as well as the nefarious program called NASA. And he died sometime in the 1980s. You can do more research on this. Also, it is also true that Hitler never had any plan to exterminate the fake Jews. That was never the plan of Hitler. The plan was immigration, which means was to get the so-called fake Jews out of Germany and into Madagascar. That was the original plan. But of course, when he found out that they wanted to go to Palestine, you can read about that in the Protocols of the Elders of Zion, because it's even there, written in right there. Well, he was very against that because he knew that they were planning for world domination. So what did they, as in the elite, as in the Jewish Zionists, have to do? They had to make him into the bad guy and trick and fool people into thinking he was the most, you know, the worst dictator on the plane. But of course, in order to fulfill their plans. But I think this card also has to do with what? It also has to foreshadow what? Hitler's brain, as in who? Could there be another so-called Hitler, another so-called dictator? Of course, we see that with Obama, we see that with Merkel. It's only going to get worse from here. But I thought it was interesting that they showed that and really showed it, because there's an agenda behind everything. But can you see it? Now here we have a picture of what's called the gay activist. Now this picture is very interesting and it's very telling. Like I said, this card game was released in the 80s, and also a majority of these cards were released in the mid 90s. So it's interesting how they have a picture showing gay activists. What is that portraying and what is that foreshadowing and alluding to? Gay marriage. And notice that the first country that approved of gay marriage was back in 2000 was the Netherlands. And after that, it was just a trickle of countries approving gay marriage. Of course, the most recent being America back a couple of months ago. Now, it's interesting. You mean to tell me that they knew about the gay agenda before there even really was one? They knew about gay marriage and everything before there really was the protests and everything? Were they planning it and staging it ahead of time? Of course they were, but that's not all they were planning. But I hope you see this and see that everything has been planned and staged ahead of time. The world and the reality that we live in has been staged. You are living in a dream unless you're awoke right now. This card is perhaps one of my favorites because it shows rewriting history, because everything you thought you knew, all the history that they tell you in your history books, they are all in fact lying to you, because they've been written by the Jewish Zionists, the same people who call themselves the real Jews, even though they're not, because even scripture says that they do lie, and they've been lying to you about their history and about whitewashed history for a long time now, haven't they? But you still think they're the chosen, don't you? You still believe every word that your history books and your textbooks and your professors and teachers tell you, don't you? Because of mind control. because even scripture says they're not the real chosen. But not only that, they like to feed us the story of, oh, there was an ice age. Oh, a comet wiped out dinosaurs. Oh, the earth is 4.6 billion years old. You all seriously better wake up fast, because that is all lies perpetrated by the same people who are rewriting and twisting and whitewashing history. Because last I checked, the original peoples of the earth were in fact black. That's not my opinion. That's not what I think. That is according to Egyptian hieroglyphics. That is according to Sumerian hieroglyphics. That is according to all those things. But what do they have to do? They have to keep you under a trance and keep lying to your face, because to fulfill their agendas of the new world order, they don't want you to know the real history and how it really happened. That's why they have to keep hiding biblical artifacts and everything else, because they don't want you to know the truth. But now that you're starting to see the truth, you can wake up and do the research on your own. Like I said, if you keep listening to what TV tells you, if you keep watching that idiot box, and if you keep listening to these Illuminati agents, well, your mind's basically going to get hypnotized, because that's exactly what is going on. They're even showing you that and telling you about the mental programming and the mind control that goes on behind closed doors, behind the TV. It's all subliminal. It's all subconscious, but you think it's still just nothing. You still think it's entertainment. I'm here to tell you that that is simply not the case. I'm telling you, nothing is ever a coincidence. Nothing just ever happens for no reason. Nothing is ever a coincidence. And what is this card showing you? It's showing you tabloids. Psychics reveal Jackie's diet plan from heaven. The tabloids can attack any secret group, and if they do, its secret status is lost for that attack, and any other groups can help attack or defend regardless of alignment. Because what is that really telling you about? And what is the picture showing you? Because all these secret societies and secret organizations and your government, along with the CIA, FBI, and other alphabet soups, they know about the fallen angels because they work with the fallen angels. But what are the fallen angels going to do? They're going to disguise themselves as aliens and UFOs. And these are going to be the disgusting creatures that they make and process in laboratories and start to show the world. Creatures that have not been seen since when? The days of Noah. But they're going to say, oh, psychics predicted, oh, psychics knew about it. They're already starting that with some predictions and so-called predictions by saying, oh, this person predicted this back in the 1900s. This person predicted it back in the 1910s. Did they really? Or did they know about it ahead of time? Oh, how strange reality really is. You're the one living in a fantasy, because this card is telling you so much truth. And it says corruption. The black market in relief supplies is a growing daily. And what this card is showing you is that it's showing you a card with the cure to certain diseases right on it. But it shows a boy who looks to be starving and looks to be needing of the cure. What is this card really showing you? The corruption of the system. Because yes, they found the cure to AIDS. Yes, they have the cure to cancer. Yes, they found the cure to all these diseases and all these so-called diseases. By the way, many of which these diseases are caused by them to begin with. They're the ones behind all the diseases through vaccines and other medicines that only make you sicker. But they know the cure as well. They're keeping the cure from you because they don't want you to know about it. By the way, there was also somebody who invented cars that could run on coconut oil and other things besides fuel. But of course, your government can't have that, can they? Why? Because of mind control, because of oil, because of corruption. They only want cars running on gas and oil. They don't want people getting cured, because then they don't make much money. Because then if people get cured, they wouldn't have to go to the hospital. And hospitals are only designed by the Freemasons to keep you sicker and sicker. They want you to continue to live in that new world order trance, relying solely on them. It's all about control. It's all about the new world order. But they even tell you that they found cures for things, but you still think that they haven't found it, do you? But now it's time to see just who the real corruption is and just where the real corruption comes from, because they're the ones showing you. But are you heeding the warning? Oh, how the elite have figured out everything ahead of time. Because what does this show? Miracle Diet Plan. Over 2 million copies sold. Get yours today. Because what? It shows you what? All those plans like Jenny Craig and all those weight loss plans and so-called weight loss plans, they only make you worse. They don't make you better. It's all a fraud. It's all a fake. It's all a hoax. Because it even shows you a woman chowing down and eating and munching on all that, only to find herself getting much, much worse. What is that showing you? Also, the control of the food, the poisoning of our food, GMOs and fluoride in the water, and all that stuff. And by the way, if you still think those miracle diet plans and stuff work, I'm telling you it doesn't. But why have you seen an uptick of these so-called diet plans and everything else with the Jenny Craigs and all the other ones within the past couple of years, mostly within the past 10 years or so? Why has it been a sudden increase now? Did they know about it before it even happened, or were they fooling us to begin with? I love how this card says exposed, because it says watch them scatter like cockroaches. It's very interesting because what, and even shows a picture of two people being recorded being exposed, just like what the Illuminati exposed. Because you can go on YouTube right now and every single video you see and type in, it'll show Illuminati exposed, Illuminati exposed, Illuminati exposed, just like the title of this video. Wow, you mean to tell me that they knew exactly what would happen? You mean to tell me that they were planning all this to begin with and knew that that word would be very, very central and important in today's world right now? Very, very interesting indeed. Very suspicious indeed. Remember, things don't just happen. Now, I thought this card was interesting too, because what does it show you? It shows you clone arrangers, cloning. If you still think cloning is a fake, well, I suggest you wake up now and see that it's not. You can also watch my other cloning videos, and you'll see that they not only clone celebrities, but they also do what? They clone politicians, they clone anyone of so-called importance, they clone the elite, and they even have them underground in secret military bases and secret underground facilities and research facilities with the parasites, lizards, and the offspring of the fallen angels. Why? Because of mind control, because they want you to think it's a fake. And don't get it twisted, this stuff is nothing new. This has been going on even in the days of Noah. It's nothing new is under the sun. But I just wanted to show you this because it's real interesting that it shows clone arrangers. Not only that, but it also shows the number 23. The number 23 shows up a lot on these cards, in case you haven't been paying attention, which is very, very interesting and very, very suspicious. Now, I thought this card was very interesting and telling because it shows you what? It shows liquor companies, and it shows with its huge advertising budget, this group gets a +4 in any direct attempt to control a media group. But look very closely at these cards. You can see what looks to be like a man inside of a bottle, which could really symbolize alcoholism. But look at this. It shows what looks to be the snout of an elephant. Why is it showing that? And why does this look like blood right here? What are they really trying to show us through that? What are they really trying to get at here? If you all have any input on this particular card, please let us know in the comment box below, because I'm actually interested to know why they're showing a snout of what looks to be like either an elephant or a pig in this card as well. Could that be alluding to something? Could that maybe represent that they put animal stuff into these products? I don't know. It's just interesting to think about and see. But like I said, you can also be the judge of that on your own as well. Now, it's interesting. They show a picture of New York, and they show, of course, crime going on. And it says, no matter what your scam, somebody in the Big Apple does it better. Isn't that the truth? And notice how it shows coastal on it. Could that be one of the cities that they're preparing for the New World Order for destruction? Of course it is. But it's also interesting that they show King Kong, or what looks to be King Kong, on top of the Empire State Building. Now, why would they show that? And especially considering since the movie King Kong came out in 2005, about 10 years after this card was released. And I know, of course, there were other earlier versions of that movie that came out in the 70s and even in the 30s, but I just thought it was interesting that they show it and allude to something, maybe something that we don't know about. What are they getting ready for? What exactly are they preparing for? A march on Washington? Wow, there's been several marches on Washington, haven't there? And we're about to see another one take place with the Democracy Spring in a couple of weeks from now. Wow, so they've been planning all this and staging it ahead of time. But we know it's them, and we know they're funding it, like the George Soros and all the other elite who are funding all this and trying to trigger these race wars and these race riots, because they need that for the New World Order. That's why they're stopping at nothing to get that done, to get that agenda done. Agenda New World Order, Team New World Order, because that's the agenda they're going for, isn't it? But you still think it's a conspiracy, don't you? But a new world order is nothing without a charismatic leader. You always need a charismatic leader. And who's the charismatic leader I can think of? Barack Obama, so called. Because that is how you fool the people into getting them to listen to you. It's all about mind control, isn't it? Oh, but we know better now because we see just the agenda. We see just what time it is, and we see not to take their word for it. This card was interesting because it shows what? Earthquake projector. Because if you don't think that they're staging these earthquakes through HARP and CERN, if you don't think that they're staging all this stuff ahead of time, then I suggest you think again. Now, fracking could have something to do with it, but I really think it has to do with these government organizations, the alphabet soups. It says this device can act once per turn. It can increase the power of any attack to destroy place or of any disaster card by two. And lately, you've been hearing a ton about earthquakes in Alaska, Oklahoma, California, and even places that you've never even heard about getting earthquakes. I wonder why that is. Could they be staging all this ahead of time, getting ready for the big ones? Oh, of course they are, but they're gonna blame it on global warming and all other things except what it's really about, won't they? Now this card is interesting because it even shows you what? Post office. And it says, of course they read your mail. And who is they? The elite, the Illuminati, the CIA and the FBI. They read all of our mail, all of our email, all of our text messages, all of our phone calls. They monitor and record every single thing that we're doing. Oh, but you think it's a conspiracy? You think it's a joke? I'm telling you, this goes much deeper than any of us could ever imagine. But why are they spying on us like that? Spying and denying? Why is the question? Because they're getting ready for the New World Order, the FEMA camps. They need to know if you're a political dissident. They need to know if you're a political terrorist. They need to know if you have some type of terrorism or if you could be an alleged suspected terrorist. Because if you're even watching this video, you could be a terrorist. You could be a terrorist for watching any of my videos. That's why YouTube has to constantly and continuously mute my videos on a daily basis because they know what they're doing. They're good at lying and they don't want you to see or hear the truth. They're good at hiding things, aren't they? Not any more. But how do you have a new world order? Stealing the plans. That's the only way it's going to work. I'm telling you, it's all about lying and stealing. That is the game of the new world order because it's really a game for them. It's all a big game to them. But you still think it, you're still living in that fantasy. You better wake up fast because I'm telling you, this goes much deeper than just the rabbit hole. But to have a new world order, you have to have world hunger, and it's just so sad and tragic and unfortunate that, of course, the elite are like this and that they're sociopaths to even allow this to go on and to fund all this because there's enough food for everyone. But of course, they have to hide it from certain locations because what they lose money that way. But it says increasingly desperate populations are hunting whales, setting up factory farms, and strip mining for scarce resources. The environment is falling apart, and nobody has time to worry about it because that's exactly what's going on. And it's so sad that our life is like this. It's so sad that the reality is like this. But that's the new world order for you, at least not for long. But we can't forget about the riots. Let's not forget about the riots because that's exactly what you must have. Upheaval. Worldwide riots continue for a third week with no sign of abatement. What are they getting ready for? Is it a coincidence that this so-called Democracy Spring, which is going to be taking place in April, that they're going to be doing riots and protesting for exactly 3 weeks? Is that a coincidence? Is that a surprise? No, it's not. And look what it says, riot, the military police state, because that's exactly what you have to have. The new world order being triggered right in front of our faces. What's another goal for the world? Another goal is what? The hand of madness. Now, why would they only just show one hand? Because what? control of the world, global or worldwide dominance, not even global dominance because the world's not a globe, but the hand of madness is what they're going for. I'm telling you, this goes much deeper than you think. They've already told us their plans and what they're planning to do and what they're going to do, but we've been ignorant for so long. But now that we know the truth, we don't have to be ignorant anymore. Lately, you've been seeing a lot of space phenomena, haven't you? You've been seeing a ton of stars that are pointing right above the pyramids and everything else. Now, whether or not they're actually true or photoshopped, I don't know. But what I do know is that they've already predicted everything. They know exactly what they're going to do, and they're even telling you what they're going to do before they do it. So now it's time to see just what time it really is. But it goes much deeper than that because what are they showing you? Crop circles. Where do you think these crop circles come from? Who do you think is in charge of them? Because I'm telling you, it's not aliens. Oh, quite the contrary. Oh, they're disguising themselves as aliens, but it's not aliens. When you're in a spiritual mindset, then you understand just what it really is. Could be wrong about this, but I thought it was interesting that they would use secular humanists because what it become popularized and glamorized around recently now. Huh, well, what are they really planning and staging? And notice how they say, while you control this group, all straight or conservative groups will be so distracted that any attacks they make against your other groups will be minus three power. Because what? It's all about control. Because many secular humanists, at least people who are asleep, don't know that both sides are controlled, both the Democrats and Republicans, both liberals and conservatives. It does not matter. Both of them are controlled and they're played by the same game, by the same team, which is the Team Elite, Team New World Order. But people still think that, oh, they have a free voice. Oh, their vote counts. Yeah, you keep thinking that because I'm telling you, it goes much deeper than that. Now, this card tells so much in just a little bit because it says immortality serum. And look at the quote and look how important that quote is. By the way, if you join us, you can live forever. Interested? What does that remind you of? The tree of knowledge, good and evil, Adam and Eve and the serpent. That's exactly what that's talking about because what's about to happen? These so-called aliens who are going to be disguised as the fallen angels, they're going to come and tell you that, hey, we can give you technology, you can become immortal, you can live forever. All you have to do is follow us and listen to us. We can be your gods. All you have to do is follow us and join us. Are you interested? Because that's exactly what they're going to tell you. They've been planning this for a long time. Nothing new is under the sun. That's exactly what the serpent did to Eve and Adam in the Garden of Eden. But you are going to be much smarter when they do that because you are just as wise as serpents because you've been doing your research. It's only going to get worse from here, and I know you probably don't want to hear that, but unfortunately, that is the sad, sad truth. And this card shows cover up, and it says, what? Play this card at any time a secret group has been successfully attacked. That attack becomes a failure. It requires an action from another secret group or your Illuminati. And it shows you burning up of evidence, just like what? Or hiding of evidence or making up evidence like 9/11 with the so-called planes that weren't really there and the Sandy hoax that didn't actually happen, but they have to cover it up and make it up in order to make you believe a lie. But now that you're doing your research and not believing a word that mainstream media and what government tells you because they do lie, you know better than that. Now, I thought this card was interesting because it shows giant kudzu and it says, disaster. This is an attack to destroy any place. It does not require an action. Its power is 30 against a coastal place, 24 against any other place. And if you watch my other previous cards, you'd see that we've been talking a lot about coastal places and coastal areas and showing monsters in coastal areas. Why do you think that is? And why do you think this one is showing that as well? Is this what they're preparing for? Is this what they're getting us ready for? I'm telling you, they already knew about the fluoride in the water because they're the ones who put it there to begin with. That's why you're seeing all that lead and Flint water and other places, and it's only spreading and trickling because they're getting ready for the new world order. But as you can see, it says fiendish fluoridators. And as you can see, it says water. And look, you see the number 23 again. I just reported on that a little bit earlier. I wonder why that is. what could they really be showing us here? It'll be the last card I show you because, like I said, there's so many cards and I probably have taken up all your time for these cards, but it's just interesting because it's like I do a list of all the cards that I want to go over and talk about, and I try to say I'm only going to stick with these list of cards. But of course, you find more cards and more cards and more cards, and then the more you see them, the more it makes you want to report on them. So it looks like I'm going to be doing a part five because there's just way more cards that need to be exposed than just this. So stay tuned for that. But this one shows, of course, early warning. What are they getting ready for? They're warning you ahead of time in media, film, TV, and all video games about what they're about to do, about what's to come. But you can keep sitting there and thinking it's a joke. You can keep sitting there thinking it's just a game and entertainment. Oh, you'll be taken for a loop when this stuff really starts to happen. Please seek Yahuwah and his true son Yahusha, that all may be well with you, that you can escape the coming destruction that is even at the door.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video presentation. If you did, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like the video, and share it on your favorite social media sites. There's a lot more to come, so stay tuned, and we'll see you back next time.